Hi everyone, and I hope you're all doing great. So welcome to my next tutorial where I'm briefly going to discuss an AWS service called AWS Global Accelerator. So you can of course search for Global Accelerator here, but I'm going to click on it here. So actually if you need help finding it, just type in Global Accelerator. So go ahead and click on that there. Okay, so I'm going to explain what this is. Now it's not a very complicated service, it's actually very simple to explain here. So basically, as we can see here, Global Accelerator is used to improve the availability and performance of our applications. But I want to go a little bit deeper and explain what this is actually used for. So basically, okay, AWS Global Accelerator is going to provide us with two static anycast IP addresses, okay? And these IP addresses only need to be configured by our users once. So in effect, what happens essentially is, let's say we were to have a global user. So let's say we have our application and we're expecting our users to be, you know, from everywhere in the world, from let's say China, United States, India, Australia, South Africa, everywhere. Now, basically with Global Accelerator, through these static anycast IPs, okay, it's going to really help in reducing latency and to, in turn, maximize the application performance, as we can see that we are utilizing, in fact, AWS's global network. So you can have up to a 60% performance improvement in your application if you utilize Global Accelerator, okay? Now, this is quite an expensive service. It can get quite expensive, but it's definitely something to look into if you have a global application and you expect users from a lot of countries or to connect to your application. So it's definitely something to look into and just have a look at. So I'm just going to, of course, now showcase you the performance here. So I have this speed test here that AWS provides us for Global Accelerator to just test out the speed comparison. Now, a really cool thing that you can do here is you can choose a file size, okay? And what you can essentially check is how the performance would be for uploading this particular file size. If you were to do it with just the internet, the normal way was the internet, or if you were to utilize AWS Global Accelerator. So go ahead and just choose a file size here. So I'm just going to choose 2 meg, and you can say start. So it's going to then run this and just show you the performance sort of improvements here that you'll have with AWS Global Accelerator and the time it takes to transfer this particular file or download it. And as we can see here, for example, in this region here of North Virginia, it is 26% faster with AWS Global Accelerator. So that it can be quite a make or break situation depending on your application. Now, you can technically see it over the other regions as well. For example, in Oregon, it is 38% faster. Now, let's just go and wait for a place in Europe. So let's look at Ireland and see what the difference is here. So you can see the benefits can be pretty good here, actually. And what I'm going to do after this is I'm just going to show you guys how you would go ahead and create a Global Accelerator. And as we can see here, with Ireland, there's 81% improvement. So you can see it is something definitely to look into, as I mentioned. All right. There we go. So don't worry, I will attach this URL in the description below, so don't worry about that. Okay, so technically you can go ahead and create the accelerator here if you'd like, but it can be a bit confusing at times. So basically in any production application, you're usually not going to have a single EC2 instance. Usually you're going to have an application load balancer, okay, which will be in front of your EC2 instances with an auto-scaling group. So technically how you would go about, you know, setting up this global accelerator, you would head over to your load balancer. Okay, so let's go there. And I just want to make sure, yeah, I always like to turn off the new EC2 experience for creating my load balancer because I always find the new experience to be a bit laggy. I'm sure some of you agree with me. It's a bit strange, so I just prefer to keep that off. So if you see the UI a bit different here, that is the reason why. So if you were to create your load balancer, typically if you have a normal web application, for 90% of us, it's going to be the application load balancer. So you'd say create. And what you'll do, I won't go through this whole process here because I have a video on how to set up a load balancer, but I just want to show you how you would go about integrating your global accelerator. So I'm just going to call this demo app LB. All right, it's going to be internet facing. We're using an IPv4 address here. Okay, and listeners, we just want a basic HTTP protocol on port 80. Availability zone, so just leave it as the default VPC. Best to choose as many availability zones, okay, to make your application highly available. And here you'll see under step one, under this section here, add-on services, you can add on a few services. And as it shows you here, you can go ahead and create an app, a global accelerator here. Okay, now the good thing about doing it here is you do not have to go through that stress of configuring it manually yourself. Okay, this is going to be integrated along with your load balancer, which is a simpler way of doing it. So technically here, you could go ahead and create your global accelerator. Just name your accelerator. So you can just call this demo app GA for global accelerator. Okay, then technically you can just leave it like that and go to configure security settings. Go to the next step, configure security groups. I'm just going to go through this briefly here. Routing, select your targets. Okay, let's just put in a target here. So I'm just going to say my TG. Okay, do bear aware. I just want to make it clear here. So do bear in mind that Global Accelerator will cost you a bit of money. I mean, technically, so does a load balancer. But I'm just showing you the process to how you would configure it and just test it. Okay, so just bear that in mind. So in actual fact, you should technically go ahead and set up your security groups. And your security settings, of course. I'm just giving you a quick demonstration to how you could integrate it and how you can see it. So you would need to just set up HTTPS if you require. Configure your security groups. I'm just going to go with my default one for now. With routing, I'm just going to create a target group here. And you just need to name one. That's all you need to do here. It will automatically be configured for you. Targets, we can just leave that blank, go to review, and we can technically go ahead and create our load balancer. So let's go ahead and create it. There we go. So it's been created, and you can see here it's also created a global accelerator as well, which is attached on our load balancer. Okay, so it's just provisioning. Okay, we do not need to wait for this entire process, but basically the important thing to bear in mind now is that we now have our global accelerator attached. So technically speaking, we can head over to this global accelerator service here, this page. And we can now see that we have a demo app here. Okay, all set and ready to go. Okay. And we can see here it gives us two static any cost IPs, which I mentioned earlier on. Okay, which is going to assist in this reduction in latency and performance improvement. Okay, so that's basically it, guys. So I just wanted to go through this with you so you at least have an idea over how you can improve the performance of your application by using Global Accelerator. Okay, now I don't want you guys to worry. So in case those of you were actually following along here, okay, I just want to show you how you can take everything off. So you can just head over to your load balancer, and technically what you'll need to do is just wait for it to actually provision. So it should say active, and then what I'm going to show you, oh, it's already there. Okay, so how to delete this, go to, make sure you've clicked on it, go to actions, and say delete. So delete your load balancer, there we go, it's gone. Now what you'd need to do is head over to Global Accelerator, and you want to go ahead and delete your global accelerator as well. So go ahead and click on that and just say delete. So we can say here, delete the accelerator permanently. This cannot be undone. Okay, it just gives you a bit of information that you'll lose your static any cost IP addresses that are assigned to this. So we won't be able to route traffic to it. So what you need to do first of all in this case is you need to disable the accelerator. And this can take 5 minutes as it says. So it's going to disable first. And what we need to do is just wait for that. And once it's disabled the accelerator, we can go ahead and just type in delete and delete it. So for those of you watching and following along, okay, what I'm going to do is just pause the video until this accelerator has been in fact disabled, and then I'm going to delete it, so you don't need to worry about any costs or anything like that. So let's just wait for that. Should be 5-10 minutes max, but let's just see. All right, so let's just wait for that. Hi everyone, so welcome back. We can now see that our accelerator is disabled, so we can just go ahead and type in delete. All right, so just say delete. Okay, so it might just take a moment. So what we may need to do is actually refresh this if it just takes a bit too long. Okay, let's just refresh this actually. Okay, and actually just refresh the page. Okay. And go ahead and click on it, delete, type it in again. And there we go. So it's busy deleting the accelerator, which we named Demo App GA. So let's just close that. And what will happen is it will take some time to go ahead and delete it, and we can see it's in progress. So we just need to, let's try this again. Okay, so it's going to take some time to do this. So what we can do again now, we can wait for this to be, there we go. It's been deleted. All right, great. So it just takes a while to disable it. When it comes to deleting, it is quite straightforward. So the disabling part is the first line here. Okay, so that's it on Global Accelerator. So just to sum it off with you guys, so if you ever want to improve the performance of your application, and like I said, you can see up to a 60% improvement, which I think is more like a good estimate, up to 60%. From what we've seen on our speed test, okay, it was at least 20%. You can expect at least a 20% improvement. But in my opinion, I would only really recommend this if you get a lot of users to your website and you can spare the expense of having the Global Accelerator. When you have a global application for many users, I think it might be a good idea to invest in and look into. But yeah, guys, so if you want to improve the performance of your application, you can go ahead and create a load balancer with, of course, your EC2 instances, auto-scaling group, and be ahead to just attach this Global Accelerator to your load balancer to improve your application's performance. Okay, so that's it, guys. I hope to help you. Just a bit of information here. What I will do is be sure to add this speed test here in the link in the description below, just to give you a bit more of a way to, you know, try it out. You can, of course, read a little bit about it here, learn more. And, of course, there is a link here to the documentation on AWS Global Accelerator here as well. And, of course, you can check all the regions. It should show you all the regions that are available. So go ahead and just, you know, check that out and see how it goes for you guys. All right. So that's it, guys. Thanks so much.